First of all, I would like to thank Luca for the organization and for the invitation. Of course, so it's always a pleasure to be in Grenoble. And so the main goal of my talk will be to explain some results about the validity or non-validity of this covering property, which is called Bezukhovich covering property for homogeneous distances on, let's say, stratified groups. Okay, so maybe the first thing I will do is to recall or to tell you, for people that are not familiar, so what is the Bezukhovich covering property in the general metric setting? Bezukhovich covering property. So maybe it will be shorter for me to write it at BCP, what follows. So a first definition, so I have a metric space. I consider a family of closed balls, B, in XD. So each ball, B, in the family comes with a center and a radius. Okay, and the first thing I will call B a Bezukhovich family. So B, let's say he's a Bezukhovich family in my metric space, XD. If two things hold, so the first one is that if I take the center of some ball in my family, XB, this center does not belong to any other ball in the family. So I will state it doesn't belong to this union where B prime is distinct from B. In B prime is in B, and this has to hold for every ball B in the family. Okay. So in terms of distances, this is equivalent, if you prefer, I can write it as if I look at the distance between two centers of two distinct balls. This has to be always strictly bigger than the maximum of the radius of each ball. Maybe and B prime, this is for all B prime. So this is equivalent, and for me, if I forget, balls are closed balls in all my talks. That's why I have strict inequality. So this is the first condition, and the second one is that the intersection of all balls in the family is non-empty. Okay, and now what is the Bezukhovich covering property? So the definition is that I will see that my metric space satisfies BCP if there exists a constant positive, and let's say bigger than one, such that the cardinality of B is less than C for every Bezukhovich family B in my metric space. Okay, so let me rephrase it in other words. So if BCP holds, this means that if you look at a family of balls, and if you cannot extract from this family a strict subfamily that still covers all the centers of the balls, then the balls in the original family have bounded overlap. It's exactly what means this thing. So here I assume that you take a family of ball, of closed ball in XD, and assume that you cannot extract a strict subfamily from this family that still covers all the centers of the balls in the original family. Then BCP also implies that all the balls in the original family have bounded overlap, which means that any point in my space can belong only to at most C balls in my original family. So which is the kind of covering property which is quite standard and known to be very useful for for many purposes.
Factor V is a function which is the number of poles covering each pole.
Excuse me? No, B is a family of balls, and card is a cardinality. So it's the number of balls in my family.
Yes, but you were saying that the number of balls overlapping was more than C, and here I read the number of balls existing.
No, I'm not. I'm saying something different. So this is a definition of BCP, okay. And an equivalent definition is assume that you have B, so an arbitrary family of balls. Closed, it takes D, and assume that there does not exist a subfamily which is strict, contained in B, but not all B, so that, let's see, I'll write it that way. I look at all the centers of the balls in my initial family, and this is not covered by F, so this is not contained. So I cannot extract a strict subfamily that still covers the centers in my initial family if BCP, then. Yeah, so I cannot extract a strict subfamily that still covers all the centers. Okay, then if BCP holds, this implies that, let me write it that way. The same C for the BCP constant. And this means that balls is this is what I say, what I call bounded overlap for the balls in my initial family. Okay, balls may not be disjointed; it would be too much, but at least they have bounded overlap. Okay. So why this is useful? And so it's so this property is named after Bezukhovich because it was the property that Bezukhovich proved for the Euclidean space, and it was one of the main arguments in his proof of the differentiation theorem for measures in the Euclidean plane. And in fact, now this has been, so the fact that BCP is a powerful tool for differentiation of measure has been extended in a general metric setting. Excuse me? I think there are works about the best constant for the Euclidean distance. It depends on the dimension, of course, and it's closely related to the compactness of the unit sphere. And you have to compute how many points at distance more than epsilon you have on the unit sphere, and so on. So, I will not be interested in computing effectively this constant, but you can try. Okay. So to give some motivation. So let me state the following theorem that assume that XD is separable and I have the Bezukhovich covering property. Then, so the differentiation theorem holds. So what is important is that it holds for every locally finite ball. Regular measures. Let's call it mu. On XD. Okay, and so what means differentiation theorem for measure mu? So this means that for every function f which is locally integrable with respect to mu, if I look at the mean value of f over a ball, the center x, so which is f of y. I take the limit when r goes to 0. This limit exists and equals f of x almost everywhere. So I do not put a name here because I do not really know. So I could put Bezukhovich for case of the Euclidean space. And later on, people realize that, well, it was the argument was much more general than just Euclidean space. Okay. And so what are examples that are well known? So it's this Euclidean space. And more generally, what is well known about is that finite dimensional normed vector spaces . So these are positive examples that satisfy Bezukhovich covering property.
So if two spaces are quasi-isometric, then both are
quasi. Excuse me?
If two spaces are quasi-isometric, then both...
I don't think so, because one of the goals of my talk will be to convince you that the validity of the Bezukhovich covering property is really not stable in any reasonable sense with respect to perturbation of the distance. And well, I have said many conjectures in that work that were at the end wrong, so now okay. Well, I don't know the answer. That's so, and on the other hand, infinite dimensional normed vector spaces do not have PCP. These are the basic, now well-known examples. Okay, so one of my goals will be to enlarge a little bit this list of examples. And in fact, in both sides, negative one, well, but also hopefully some positive examples with PCP. And here maybe a few more comments about this. So I'm here. So BCP is a sufficient condition for studying arbitrary measures. And in fact, one can write an if and only if condition if one, well, introduce something related to BCP. This is the notion of sigma finite dimensional distances. So this is a notion that is due to David Price. So I have XD, a metric space, and I will say that D is finite dimensional on a subset y of x if there exist two constants, so c bigger than 1 and r which is positive and maybe plus infinity. So we allow it so that the cardinality of b is less than c, and here they should hold for every Bezukhovich family B in my matrix space in XD. And here I'm asking that all the centers of the balls belong to Y, to my subset, so with center on Y, and with radius, all the radius of balls in my family are less than this number R. So for instance, BCP holds on XD, rephrased is exactly means that D is finite dimensional on X, and we here with R equals plus infinity. Okay. And now I will say that distance is sigma finite dimensional if I can write X as a countable union of subsets on which D is finite dimensional. X can be written as a countable union of subspace, and D is finite dimensional on Xn for every n. And also the result that I would like to give as another motivation to look at Bezukhovich covering properties. So this is due to Price. And so it's an if and only if. So now the assumption, which are not so strong, is separable and complete. And now the differentiation theorem holds for every measure, so here locally finite or well regular, so for every measure on XD, this is equivalent to the fact that the distance is sigma finite dimensional. So this is one way to see Bezukhovich covering property, or this extension of Bezukhovich covering property as the main tool in this story of differentiation of measures. And the strength of this theorem is that here it allows to study arbitrary measures, not only few ones with specific properties. Okay. Okay, so for instance, the example of sigma finite dimensional distances are Riemannian distances on Riemannian manifolds of class at least C2 or something. Well, that's nothing. Assume it's smooth. Okay. Riemannian distances are sigma finite dimensional. Okay, so now my goal is to try to see if there are other examples than this one that satisfies in kind of properties. Because as you see, in fact, it turns out that asking for BCP is a quite strong condition on the metric space. Okay. What I would like to say also is that BCP is very far from being stable under perturbations. What do I mean by that? I mean that BCP is really a family for property of balls, and it's much more related to the shape of the balls and to the distance itself. And for instance, it's not a bi-Lipschitz invariant in the sense that you can have two distances very close to be that are bi-Lipschitz invariants, one with BCP and the other one without BCP. Maybe I will go back to that with more details a little bit later. Okay, and so the question, so what I'm going to say is mainly based on a gen work with Enrico Ledonné. So the question was what happened for, let's say, sub-Riemannian distances on Carnot groups or sub-Riemannian distances on submanifolds. And then we say, so what was known just before, maybe it goes back to the 80s, it was noted by Sawyer and Whedon, and in fact, independently and at the same time by Corani and Riemann. That if you look at the first Heisenberg group, equipped with the Kurani distance, which I will call DK. So this is Kurani distance. So this metric space does not satisfy PCP. Okay, and what was commonly...
And does the differentiation theorem hold in this case?
Yes, maybe something, because probably I will not have time and I will forget. If I am working on a stratified group with a homogeneous distance, the fact that BCP holds is equivalent to have the distance sigma finite dimensional. So one sense is trivial. And the other one is just because here I'm working in a setting where I have translation and dilations. So if something happens at some place somewhere, it should happen everywhere. OK, so in this setting of homogeneous distances on stratified groups, the if and only if here, I can put if and only if I have BCP on the metric space. Okay. So for instance, for the if you work with the Kurani distance, there exists at least one measure so that you cannot differentiate with respect to this measure. Yeah, so it's a Kurani distance. Maybe I will recall the definition after, but it's one of the classical homogeneous distance on Heisenberg. So, and so what was commonly believed after that is that there should not exist any homogeneous distance on a stratified group with BCP. That was. And for instance, the first natural question is if you replace it here, the Kurani distance, with a Subriemannian distance, which is which could be your favorite homogeneous distance, what happens? Okay. And so, let me state. And so, unfortunately, in the so. Subriemannian distances. And here what I'm going to explain to you are negative results in the sense that we do not have BCP or sigma finite dimensional Subriemannian distances. So let me maybe the theorem, so which is joint with Enrico. So we have no BCP on, let me see, it will be shorter to work that way, on Carnot groups. And for me, a Carnot group means a stratified group. And yeah, I assume of type at least two, because otherwise I am in the case of a normed vector species, equipped with a Subriemannian distance. So BCP never holds for these distances. And well, I'm not going to explain the proof because it's a negative result. And I would like to present positive results. Let me just say that there are two main steps in the proof. So the first one is another result, maybe more than 10 years ago. It was no BCP in H1. So first Heisenberg group with the standard Subriemannian distance on H1. So in fact, this result was a little bit more general, but it was using, so the technicalities in the proof were using some regularity of the distance and of length minimizer, which are not known to be hold in the general case. So this was not enough. The techniques in this proof were not enough to handle the general case of any stratified group. And now with Enrico, we are able to prove that if you argue back contradiction, and if you have a Carnot group with BCP, then this would imply that H1 with its usual Subriemannian distance should also satisfy BCP. This is known not to be true. Okay. Okay, so this is a negative result, and there is a consequence for subriemannian manifolds, is that subriemannian distances on the subriemannian manifold are not sigma finite dimensional. So in my terminology, in a subriemannian distance is not allowed to be Riemannian. So it's subriemannian that are not Riemannian. Okay. On a subriemannian manifold are not sigma finite. Okay, and just a hint of the proof of this fact. So this will be a consequence of the previous theorem on stratified groups, because here we use the fact that at regular points, a subriemannian manifold admits a metric tangent space in the sense of Gromov, that is a Carnot group. Okay, and what has to be checked is that the way you take the limit when looking at metric tangent preserves the validity of BCP. Okay, and then you end up with a contradiction. That's it. Okay. Okay. Okay, so now what's going on? So hopefully this is not the end of the story, because so as you know, subriemannian distances are on a Carnot group. Are homogeneous, so they are left invariant and homogeneous with degree one with respect to the natural family of dilations. And
when this is a general fact that the BCP is preserved or not with the wrong
quantum color,
it's related to the
subriemannian. Oh, it's not related, but well, BCP. It depends what kind of limits for distance you take to preserve BCP. Well, maybe I can explain after, because it's but it's not a difficult case. But the way you take limits when you look at metric tangents is a good one with respect to BCP in the general case. It's not specific. No, it's not specific. On a stratified group, there are always many other homogeneous distances than the subriemannian ones. And one also knows that any two homogeneous distances in that context are by Lipschitz equivalent. So for many purposes, you do not really care about a specific choice of a homogeneous distance if your goal is to prove some property that is invariance modulo by Lipschitz equivalent distances. Okay, but if you can find some homogeneous distance with BCP, then maybe it could be a good distance to work with, because you can use this covering property. And maybe now I can write more precisely what I mean. So far, there is actually theoretically some hope to find homogeneous distances with BCP, because BCP is not by Lipschitz invariant. And maybe I can write two results that are more precise. Let's see. So in the general metric setting, I take XD, so it's a metric space. And my only assumption is that there exists some accumulation point. So this theorem will say that it's, in this general setting, easy to destroy the basic of each covering property. So in the following sense, so for any constant C between 0 and 1, there exists a distance BC on X so that how can I write it? DC plus D bigger than C times D. So this means that DC is by Lipschitz equivalent to D, and I get the constant C as close as I want to 1. So very cool. So that BCP does not work. X DC. So of course, if D does not satisfy BCP, I'm not saying anything. But you can think of a metric space that satisfies BCP. There are always distances that are as close as you want from this distance with BCP in that sense, that do not satisfy BCP. Okay. So this was actually we get a proof of that with Enrico, with exactly this statement, and we took that as an exercise from Price's paper, which stated a statement about sigma finite dimensional measure, but without proof. So we just so this is, and conversely, there is another fact that there exist examples of metric space XD without BCP. So here I start with a distance that do not satisfy BCP, but in such but that are such that you can find the sequence of distances with BCP. That approaches. So that for every epsilon positive, there exists a distance d epsilon. Such that so here maybe the word d epsilon is. Okay, and that BCP holds on X D epsilon. Okay, so well, it's difficult if you only know something about one specific distance. It's very difficult to guess what will happen for other Lipschitz equivalent distances. Okay, so here my plan is to have enough time to give you an explicit example, which will come from the first Heisenberg group. D will be the core any distance, for which we know that we do not have BCP, but we can find homogeneous distances with this property and hold with BCP. So. Okay, so now let me state, so now we got with Enrico a characterization of stratified groups that admits homogeneous distances with BCP. So not all, unfortunately, but so there exists homogeneous distances. And in that case, in fact, it always exists infinitely many such distances. Just one is enough. With BCP, one is 25. If and only if the step of the group is 1 or 2. That's the way. So what is new in this theorem is that so stratified groups, homogeneous distances on stratified groups of step one are exactly finite dimensional norm vector spaces. So it was already known, and in fact known that for every homogeneous distances, in that case we have BCP. So what is new is that now for step two stratified groups, so for instance Heisenberg group, you can find some homogeneous distances with BCP. But if the step is higher, so 3 or higher, then there is no hope. There do not exist any homogeneous distance with BCP. Okay. So my plan is not to give a proof of this because
so it's sorry, there it was a strict
No, larger. That also it means that sub-Riemannian distance on a stratified group of step 2 is not a good candidate for BCP.
Okay.
I will. So my plan is not to prove the theorem. You have to believe me, but at least maybe it depends on the time, to give you explicitly, in some special cases, what are the good distances for step 2 stratified group, which means what is the positive part of the result. Okay, so maybe, so I want to, let's say, give a hint of the proof of, I take, so I'll just look at step 2 stratified group. And the first case, so the main geometric case to understand is the case of what I will call FR2, which is a free nilpotent D group of step 2. And R is an integer. Here I will give you a precise formula for these good distances, this BCP. So I need to introduce some terminology. So if I look at the Lie algebra, so this is the free nilpotent of step 2, which means the Lie algebra can be written as a direct sum of two subspaces, V1 and V2. And the dimension of V1 is R, so this is a rank. The dimension of V2 is, so I am a free nilpotent case, which is what mean. So let me call X1, XR, a basis of the first layer of V1. And then, if I look at brackets, XY, XG, so this is the basis of the second layer. Now I will denote by norm. So this is a Euclidean norm. FR2 that makes this basis orthonormal. Making so x1, xr, and z bracket. Now I can identify the free nilpotent phi group with the Lie algebra using exponential map, okay? And I will look at the following set in my group that I call AR, which is in fact the Euclidean ball with respect to this Euclidean structure with centered at the origin and with radius R. So let me write it. AR is point P is in my group with Euclidean norm with respect to this Euclidean norm. Yes. And I want to define something that we call dr from P to Q. Okay, I have to. It's the infimum. Yes. Lambda positive, so that if I take the dilations of factor 1 over lambda of P minus 1. And Q, this belongs to AR. So this is just a definition. And a first result that was proved by Ebisch and Sikora is that you can find values of R that are small enough so that this defines a homogeneous distance on your group. And so what is difficult here, so the point to check is that if you take this definition, it will be left invariant and one homogeneous because you define it in such a way. What you have to check to have a distance is as you have the triangle inequality, which is the point that, so triangle inequality with constant one. Okay, but it turns out that you can find values of the radius so that you have a distance. In the 80s, I think, or 90s, I don't remember. So there exists raster such that for every R, VR defines the homogeneous distance on. And in fact, this the result is more general. For any homogeneous group, you can construct homogeneous distances in that way. Taking, so here this distance is constructed so that the unit ball centered at the origin for dr is exactly the set ar that I took here. So it's basically the same construction as you construct norms on finite dimensional vector spaces, looking at convex sets and saying this convex set I want it to be the unit ball for my norm. So it's exactly the same kind of argument to construct the distance. Okay. And also here what.
And I guess you don't know the value of C such that the specific example.
No, I don't really know.
Maybe I as a function of R.
No, I don't know. So the next step I didn't, but probably you guessed. So what we prove is that BCP holds for these distances.
Okay.
Here, in fact, here we say as soon as we have a positive R, such as dr is a homogeneous distance, then we have BCP. And here I use these facts just saying that I really have examples. But in fact, maybe what I can say just right now that this characterization, in fact, we have a more general characterization about graded groups with homogeneous distances that satisfies BCP. And here, for every R, you can check that this is a quasi-distance. So we have. So the characterization also for quasi-distance, which means you allow the multiplicative constants in the triangle inequality in the right-hand side. And then we can prove, and balls and everything makes sense for quasi-distances. And what we prove is that for any R, this is a homogeneous quasi-distance on FR2, and it satisfies BCP. OK, but for some purposes, it's good to know that the quasi-distance is a natural distance. So that's so, no, in fact, we never tried to compute the basic constants in concrete examples, so I'm not able to say. But now what I would like to stress is that when R equals 2, F22 is the Heisenberg group, the first Heisenberg group, and then dr for some specific value of R is related to the Carani distance. So. So in H1, which is F12 and step 2, I take R equals 2. It follows from Ebisch's equal results that D2 in that case is a homogeneous distance. And I have the following. So here, for me, I take H1, I will identify it with L2. Times R with the usual convention that all you know about that. And what I can write as a formula, T4, I will give the distance from the origin to the point. So V is in R2, Z is in R. So this is, so it's D2. I think I will have to put some, so this is you can forget the multiplicative constant because you do not care for BCP. So this is, you just write the good formula. So this is, so modulo multiplicative constant, this distance with Bezukhovich covering property in H1 is given by the square root of the Euclidean norm square of the horizontal component plus the Courani distance from 0 to the point square. And maybe I can give here what is the Courani distance for people just to, you can check that it is a homogeneous distance. It is, well, should be norm of B square plus well, here of course I did not tell you what is my convention for the group law, and I took a convention so that 16 is a good constant to put here. But okay, let's skip some technical details. Okay, so this is the Courani distance. One knows that this distance does not satisfy BCP on H1. But if you look at this distance, and you had it pseudo distance, in fact, here, and you take the L2 mean of this thing, well, by a magic argument, this new distance satisfies BCP on Heisenberg. Maybe it's something I can say, but I don't know if it has something to do with BCP, but, well, so this, you can find this formula just by computations. So it's, well, in fact, this distance is already appeared previously in the literature because Li and Nauer use it to prove that H1 equipped with this distance D2 is, yes. No, I think if I take a dilation here, yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Now it has to be homogeneous. So it's, yeah. It's in this lambda square. Okay. This is homogeneous. Okay. Okay. So with this distance is what is called of negative type. Which means that the snowflake H1 equipped with the square root of D2 is isometric to a subset of a Hilbert space. So he's, isometric to a subset. Okay, so this was proved by Li and Nauer. Okay, and they use that to give a counterexample to a famous conjecture in computational sciences that I will not be able to explain. But well, what is, well, maybe it's just a curiosity that, well, we end up with the same distance. And here also, taking snowflakes can be related to Bezukhovich covering property because of a result of Aswad that said if you have a doubling metric space, then the snowflake is by Lipschitz equivalent to a subset of a Euclidean space. So that's BCP. So I really don't know what means or what I've just said, but there are, seems to be some links about among all these properties. Okay. Okay, so how many times? Because I don't know. 12 times.
13 minutes.
Oh, okay. Okay, so maybe I will not have time to explain why now, if I take a stratified group of state, at least three, there cannot exist homogeneous distances with BCP in that case, which is hard part also of the proof. There are two. So here the if and only if both parts contains a non-trivial geometric argument inside. So now what I would like to say, so to explain more recent results with Sebastiano Nicolosi-Golo about distances with BCP on the Heisenberg group, where in fact you can almost characterize homogeneous distances with BCP. And one of the consequences will be that here I can put an epsilon that is arbitrary. I still have a homogeneous distance, and this distance still have BCP if epsilon is strictly positive. Okay. And this will give the example that I already spoke a little bit about of a metric space with a distance which is decay without BCP, but with epsilon, this is by Lipschitz equivalent and with BCP. Okay, so let me try to give some more precise statement. So this is ongoing work, but almost finished. So the preprint should appear soon. It's a plan. Okay, but I can state some results. So I am working in, I think the first as Heisenberg group with a homogeneous distance I call D. And there is a way to describe the unit ball center that the origin for homogeneous distance. You could BD, center 0 is all this one. Then you can write it at point VZ in H1. So that V is some case, so maybe I will write and explain after. So this old N where here K, here it's a subset of R2. So I take the convention H1 is R2 times R for me. It is compact, convex. So usual sense in Euclidean R2 contains zero in its interior and is symmetric. Minus K. And phi is a function defined on K, non-negative. And it is locally Lipschitz. Phi, it's locally Lipschitz in the interior of K. So this is. So I'm saying, so here it's just the horizontal projection of the unit ball K, and you can write a profile for the spheres, for the unit sphere, using some function which has some very little regularity, but at least locally Lipschitz in the interior. So this has to be proved, and this was a result of Sebastiano together with Enrico. And now we try to exploit this way of looking at balls in H1 to find some condition of the profile that ensures the validity of BCP or not. Okay. So the first theorem is the following. So I will look at rotationally invariant distances, which means that the profile is a radial function. Okay, so assume that phi of v is given by little phi of the norm of v for some function phi in some interval, which is even. So it exactly means that if I take rotation around the z-axis, my distance is invariant. Yes, in fact, here I assume that k is a disk. Yeah, exactly. Okay. It's just so k will be the disk. Okay. And I assume that phi. I need to assume, so here I just know that phi is locally Lipschitz, but we need more. So I will assume that phi is C1 on the interior, so on the open interval. And also, and I also need to assume that phi prime of S divided by S is bounded near zero. Then BCP holds if and only if there exists some positive number m such that phi prime of S is less than minus m times S for every S minus r. Okay. Okay, so assuming some a little bit of regularity about the distance or the unit balls, we can have a characterization here. What is quite clear if you write precisely what Bezukhovich covering property means, it implies automatically that the profile starting from the north poles has to be decreasing. Okay. But you did more than just decreasing, and one way to have a statement is that one. And here you can use this theorem to prove that maybe I just can write it here. I write the epsilon, I'll put epsilon here. This theorem applies to these distances here. You can write the profile and check that you have the good hypothesis. So it gives BCP for these distances for every epsilon positive. Okay. And maybe if I have time here, also we have something about general profile, which also gives existence of homogeneous distances with BCP that are not rotationally invariant. So BCP has nothing to do with some symmetric condition of or rotational invariance. Sorry, just yes. Okay, maybe it will be a little bit more technical. So now I assume that so there are two assumptions. So the first one is there are m positive, and there is an angle alpha, which is 0 and pi over 2, such that for almost every v in the interior of k, except the origin, and for all W2. If I have the unoriented angle between V and W that is less than alpha, this implies that the gradient of phi of V scalar produced with the values. So this is the first condition that in the rotational invariant case is very similar to that one, in fact equivalent to that one, The second condition is that something that looks like this condition here. So the second one is there exists kappa strictly positive and there exists m. So that if I look at, so I look at kappa small enough so that the ball, Euclidean ball with reduced kappa is included in the interior of K, which is always possible. And also for almost every V, the norm of so if I have these two hypotheses, only with phi which is like here, then BCP holds. So maybe. So just here you can construct the last thing. Plenty of examples of distances with profiles that satisfy this hypothesis without any rotational invariance or things like that. So this gives, in principle, a large class of homogeneous distances on the first Heisenberg group with BCP. Okay, so my time is over, so stop here.